Nextcloud Flow is a complete new workflow engine. It really enables us to automate all kinds of boring processes. I mean, this is interesting for organizations, for governments, even for home users, because it's quite powerful and very, very easy to use. The principle is, of course, very obvious and very easy. Nextcloud provides all the different functionalities from real-time collaboration to document management to notifications, tables, AI, and lots of other things. And Nextcloud Flow sits in the middle, connects all of that together, and yeah, makes it like super powerful and very easy to use. As I said, useful for a lot of people, but really today I want to look at it through the lens of the public sector, because as I said earlier, the government is an area who really needs this kind of automation to really move forward. And I think the public sector has some unique challenges. So the first challenge is, of course, digitalization in the first place. So I talk a little bit about Germany here. So because I'm from Germany, and Germany, we have some specific challenges. Digitalization is really lagging behind. A lot of government processes are done by pen and paper, fax machines, basically, in a lot of cases still. So digitalization of the government is a big challenge. Then, of course, then the question is, how do we do this? Can we do this in a way that it actually provides digital sovereignty, so the government is actually in control of what's going on, protecting the citizens, and yeah, basically have a system that's really sustainable? Next challenge. Then, of course, there's the question about resilience, right? Does the whole system still works if, like, I don't know, rely on a cloud system from the other side of the planet, it suddenly goes down, or there's some undersea cable like cut from whatever because of a war or something you don't really know right nowadays. So resilience is really, really important. So can the government have digital resilience for the services they provide? And then last but not least, the question is, of course, is there a way to create like a real digital government? Right? This is not only important because it's like convenient and makes everything faster and better. It also has to do with like being more lean, being more forward-looking. And if you really have like trouble like hiring great people, then of course IT should help to create like a digital government that works for everybody and is like just cheaper, faster, better, more transparent. And this is of course the real goal. In Germany, we have a specific law that I want to talk about for a second. It has this very funny German word name, Onlinezugangsgesetz. Right? It basically means that the government is forced to provide all the services the government provides to the citizens in a digital way. It basically says it's no longer acceptable that people need to go in there or sending faxes or letters or something, but it really should do all of that in a digital way. This is the Onlinezugangsgesetz, and this is a law that put into place a while ago, and it's basically in process of being executed. Unfortunately, this all goes really, really slow and needs to be sped up and becomes faster. And the other thing that's interesting is that actually in the law, there's a mandate that all of that should be done with open source. And the interesting thing is that all these initiatives that exist already to do this, none of them is really completely open source, like really from the full, from back to bottom, from the platform until the process itself. So there is no real solution for that at the moment. And this was also a big motivation from us as Nextcloud. Okay, like we have the tools, we have the capabilities, let's build this and provide this platform where it's like super easy to automate these processes in a complete open source way. There's another interesting principle in Germany. This is the so-called einer für alle EFA Prinzip. It basically means that if one organization like a city implemented like a Fachverfahren, a process already, then this should also be usable by another city, right? You share with each other. And I personally find this very interesting and funny because this is exactly the open source principle, right? This is exactly how the open source community works, exactly how Nextcloud, for example, is built. We are collaborating, we're sharing with each other, and so this is how we all get together stronger. So of course, this is another example which says, okay, this all should be done with open source. Okay, but what means done now? It's actually not so hard. There's always a way where some request coming in, something happens, someone wanted to register dog or wants to do something else with the government, then the data needs to be stored in a central way, it needs to be processed, like checked and approved. And at some point, then there's a confirmation sent out, and then the process is basically done. And this is quite simple, actually. And we at Nextcloud are really happy because we have all the pieces already in place, right? We have all the file management, we have all the communication capabilities, we have the office document management capabilities. We have everything already in place. It's just not automated yet. And this is why we built and extended the OCS API, the Open Collaboration Services API, to become like a standard where all these different things, these backend activities I talk about in a second, can be scripted and automated and put together. Again, an open standard with an open source implementation for open source business processes, Fachverfahren. So this is what we're building here as a standard. And of course, the version 1.0 is available as part of this release. So let's look into this a little bit more detailed. We checked all the different processes and we checked what is needed there to do this. And it's just standard things like file management, sending, receiving emails, processing emails, extracting attachments and so on, payment processes, archiving, approval processes and so on. And we built like APIs and implementations for all of them as part of OCS. So with a very, very simple script, you can basically put all those different things together and you can model such a process to, again, to register your dog maybe. But this is very easy, scriptable with just a few lines of code for everybody. But we wanted to take another step and make this like even better and even easier. So we put a no-code and low-code platform on top of that. So you can actually do all of those things now in a graphical way. You note we have to write a script. You can really do this in a graphical way with a mouse in the web browser and model these processes. And this becomes now super, super easy. So let me show you how this looks. This is just an example. It's usually always starts with some kind of event. Something comes in, again, someone wants to have, I don't know, apply for a new passport or something, and then some kind of process is going through, something happens, and then something is maybe called stored in Nextcloud tables and then approved later. So it's quite a standard flow chart, basically, that you can model here in a graphical way. And of course, the backend of all these actions are all the Nextcloud functionalities you already know and use every day. For example, Nextcloud Mail. Obviously, Nextcloud Mail is very good with receiving, sending emails and managing emails. So we build an API that is all can be automated and scriptable. So we can receive mails, we can parse mails, we can check the signatures, you can generate a mail response and so on. So this all can be very automated and very easy. Another example is forms. So Nextcloud Forms is an application where you can build all kinds of forms and you can put in data, and then we extended it now that the data that is submitted with such a form can be stored directly in Nextcloud tables for further processing. And we also extended Nextcloud Forms that a form that is generated is embeddable in other web pages. So for example, if you're a city and you want to make it possible that on the city website, you register to some event or apply for childcare, kindergarten place or something, then this can be done via form from Nextcloud Forms directly on the website of the city in a very easy way. Then, of course, there's Nextcloud Tables. We heard all about it like earlier, a super powerful tool to handle structured data. We extended it in a way that you can import and export these schemas and share it with others. That's what I said earlier. This is required by the law. So it's basically possible that one organization is modeling some management tool for something and then shares it with others. And this is super easy possible. And this is why we build this on top of Nextcloud Tables. Then there's the Nextcloud Assistant. This is our AI tool, which is also something that can be used as part of such a process, for example, for checking the plausibility of some data. You can automatically check if what is submitted by someone looks like, I don't know, spam or is wrongly filled out a form or some other mistakes, and automatically you can check and process it with AI systems, and this is also deeply integrated. Then earlier we heard from Michael and the office section that we can now generate office documents and PDFs in an automatic way with templating and filling out forms. This is done in a graphical way, as we saw earlier. But one of the main reasons why we built this feature in the first place is because we also want to do this in an automatic way. So this is all now scriptable, and you can generate, like, I don't know, answer PDFs and auto parse other PDFs and really handle this automatically, also including signing of them. So this all sounds all great, but a little bit like abstract maybe. So let's go through some concrete examples. So the first example we picked is if you want to deregister a company. This is one of those standard processes that the government provides. Second example is you want to apply for a childcare place, a kindergarten. And the third example is something that every organization maybe wants to have, is like approval of share links or something like that. Because remember, Nextcloud Flow is a full automation platform. It is useful for the government, as I said, but it's also useful for all kinds of other organizations. This is the example of the third point here. Okay, so let's get started. Maybe you want to deregister your company, and the process is that you need to send a PDF that you filled in, all your data by mail to the government. Then we can do this now. We can automatically receive this kind of mails. We can pass them. We can extract the attachment, the PDF, and pass the PDF and put everything that's in the PDF then in Nextcloud tables, for example, that we have the data in a abstract way. And then let's look at like Nextcloud Flow. It looks like that. The data comes in. It's like passed and put into a table row, maybe. Then maybe part of the process is some kind of payment. Maybe this process costs you 10 euros or I don't know. Then we can automatically generate like a payment link. We can put it into an email, send it back to the citizen so they can then do the payment. And once the payment is done, the same process starts and it goes through some different steps, maybe also manual approval steps, right? Not everything can be automatic. Maybe also a human should look at it, does this. And it then deregisters the company from the registry, because that's the process. And then it generates maybe a confirmation PDF, which is then sent back. So this is like fully automated and like really super nice and powerful. And this really saves so much time, has a very nice digital interface to the citizen, don't have to go in, don't have to look for an appointment and so on. And it's also completely open source. Second example is if you want to apply for a kindergarten place, maybe in this case, it's not by mail. Still, sending mails is fine. It doesn't feel to me like fully digital. But in this case, maybe you use a form. Maybe this is a form on the website, as I described earlier, with Nextcloud Forms. Of course, this also supports normal API calls. So if you want to have a mobile app where you can do that, it's totally possible. It's just a different input here. And then the third example, a lot of people can relate to that, that you automate some kind of other processes, your vacation process in your organization, or in this case, the approval of a share link. And this is, of course, also very easily possible, and you script it and really adapt it to the needs of your organization.